listen carefully. The informations are the title of your coding. Okay. So what you are going to perform? Whether you are going to perform half adder or full adder or half subtractor or full subtractor, 4-bit adder or 4-bit multiplier, it has to be clearly given as a title. And then you have to mention the design, whether you are going to use Verilog or BSDL language. So we are going to use Verilog language, whether you are given the code in behavior level or structural level or data flow level, it has to be clearly mentioned. What thing you are going to upload must have all this information. Next to the author, your serial number, laboratory slot number, registration number, your name, your mobile number, email ID. So these things must be there in your sheet. After that, you have to declare model HA. You have to give your registration number. Registration number, your slot serial number. Okay. So you can give your serial number underscore slot underscore registration number. Within bracket, you have to provide your sensitivity list of input and output. So what are the inputs and outputs has to be specified. So either you can follow like this input and then the output, or you can mention the output and then the input, your wish. Okay. Mostly we will be following this method, output and then the input. You can mention sum and carry are the output, A and B are the inputs. So here whether it is vectored or scalar, it is not a matter. You can mention the labels, whether it is a 3-bit or a single bit input, okay, that is not a matter. You have to just mention the labels. Okay. So what are the labels we are having? Sum and carry for output, A and B for inputs. So what is it? It is a model for performing 1-bit addition. So what is this command? For every line you have to provide a command. So model for performing 1-bit addition, I am giving the command. So all the commands must start as similar to your C language, double slash. Okay. So you must write command for each and every line of your coding, what you are going to write in your CAT examination, in your term and examination, as well as in your lab examination. Sir, I will not comment any line means, don't expect any marks from us. That's all. So this time it will be very serious. Last time I said you have to use color coding for defining. Many students have not followed that. This time it will be very serious. No marks will be provided. Those who are not following the rules and regulation of answer. With the comments, and comment has to be differentiated from the coding segment. So coding segment in one color means color, color for your comments must be different. What you are going to upload in that also, and what are you going to write in your term and examination, whether lab or theory, and your CAT to examination. Sir, I am not going to follow anything means, don't expect anything. So no marks will be provided. So input AB, these are the inputs what we are going to use for our coding, output sum. So input AB, you can define as input A colon input B, no problem, line by line. Or you can define all the inputs commonly, A comma B comma C comma D, whatever inputs you are going to define. Output sum and carry. So output sum comma carry also you can define, or output sum, output carry, you can define. After that, you have to use assign keyword for assigning the manipulations. Here what we have to know, to write this step of code, we have to know the Boolean expression. If you know the Boolean equation, and if you know the symbolic representations of your signals which have been combined using AND operation, OR operations, XOR operation. Here you can see that carry is being performed or obtained from A and B. Okay, so you are going to perform AND operation between the inputs A and B to obtain carry. Similarly, you are going to perform an exclusive OR operation between A and B to perform sum, to obtain sum. Okay, so you are going to perform XOR operation to obtain sum. You are going to perform AND operation to obtain carry. Okay, so the keyword assign has to be used. Carry is equal to A ampersand B. The ampersand signal is nothing but AND operation. The power symbol is nothing but XR operation. These operation symbols are been given in the Xerox material. I hope everyone have your Xerox material in your hand. Okay. So end the model. This is the last statement of your program. So the end model will be ending the program whatever you are designed. So this is totally about how to write a program for app order if you know the Boolean expression. Similarly, if you know the truth table, you will see next. If you know the structural level, the structure of your design, you will be going for the next method. So now for this, we are going to write the test bench. What is this test bench? Test bench is nothing but executing the program by predefined vectors. Okay? The values are being provided in a tabulated form. Okay? So either we will be using a for loop for generating that, or we will be providing the inputs continuously according to the truth table. Half order truth table is 00011011. Four inputs has to be provided, four combinations of inputs, 00011011. So that has to be provided through a Verilog code. So what is this? Test bench is nothing but a Verilog code to execute that program. No need to force or provide the inputs. Other than that, we will have the test bench. How to write the test bench? The model half order space T underscore B, or it is underscore TB. So TB stands for test bench. Half adder, for which model you are going to write the test bench. So all the collection of test vectors are called as a test bench. For the first statement of the test bench, you will have whatever you have defined as input in your main model has to be redefined here as registers. The inputs has to be redefined as a register. Okay. Like in C language variables, here we have to define as a register. Second thing, the outputs has to be redefined as wire. So in this thing, the outputs has to be redefined as wire. So what are the outputs in our model? Carry and sum, it has been redefined as wire. What are the inputs we are having? A and B, it has been redefined as register. After this, we have to call that model. So like C language function calling, there also we are calling the model. So what we are going to do, we are going to give the label of the model, whatever we are using. So here I am giving HA serial number underscore means you just copy the total three, whatever you have given in your model. And use it here. HA underscore serial number underscore slot underscore registration number I have provided means you use the same thing. After this, you are going to give a label for your model. So I am given unit under test, UUT. You can give any label. I have given unit under test. So half order unit under test. For readability purpose, I have made as UUT. So within bracket, what I am going to do is, I am going to state that A is being mapped to A, B is being mapped to B, sum is being mapped to sum, carry is mapped to carry. So why are these things you are giving? We are going to give that in C language functions, what you do, you will be passing the parameters. So here also we are passing the parameters. We are mentioning to which particular signal, input signal, what is to be sent. Okay. So it defines that A is to be sent to A, B is to be sent to B. Okay. So in this method, what is the advantage is, no, there is no requirement that you have to follow this method, sum and carry, then A and B. Okay. No sir, I have to follow that means you can give within bracket sum carry A comma B. Okay, that is nothing but you have to know how they are defined. Here we are not going to know how they are defined, what are the inputs, in which way they are defined, nothing. We are just assigning the inputs appropriate labels and we are mapping. After that, what we have to give is nothing but initial begin, so initial condition, what has to be function, this should be given here. So initial we are having, similarly always block is there. For your test bench we will be using initial block. Okay. So in initial block what you are going to give, at, this is nothing but at symbol at 10. Okay. Asterisk 10 is nothing but at 10 nanoseconds. So everything will be, or 10 delay period. It can be nanosecond or microseconds or whatever be. Okay. Yes. At that particular instant of time, what is the input for A and B? So input A is equal to 0. So 1 bit. 1 bit is 1 dash B. So what is this B? B stands for binary information 0. So semicolon, B is equal to 1 bit 0. So this is nothing but I am going to force A equal to 0, B equal to 0. After that, dollar display is nothing but the DAS command for displaying the information in the screen, okay, or in the console window. So this is similar to your scanf printf statement. Printf statement in C language. This is DAS command equivalent to printf. So whatever information I want to print within bracket, I will give. So slash n in C language, it is nothing but new line. Here also new line. One bit half adder. Okay, new line. After that, what I am going to do? Hash 10, the next data I am going to do. A is equal to 0, 1. This is nothing but 0, 1 I am doing. Then I am displaying dollar display in underscore A is equal to percentage B. Percentage B stands for, it's a binary data. In your C language also you will be giving percentage F for floating point, percentage D for decimal number system. Okay. So here we are going to have binary number system percentage B. Okay. So which is equal to a pi symbol I am giving the for lining. Okay. IN underscore B percentage B. Output and sum and output carry. So percentage B is nothing but what is the parameter we are giving? A, B, sum and carry we are having. Similarly, the next data I am going to give 1 and 0. And then next data 1, 1. Okay. The four data has been applied. So we are going to get the display of 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So that has been commented here. After this, I am going to display the value of the final stage and then stop after 10. So what is this 10? For every 10 delay, I am going to have new data which has been forced to that particular input vectors. And the corresponding outputs are being tabulated. End, finally. So this is the way you have to write the test bench. And final statement will be end model. Similarly for full adder, you have to mention the title full adder, very large behavior level, central level or data flow level, other informations. So full adder will have A, B, C in, three inputs, sum and carry output. So input A, B, C in, output register sum and output. Okay. So I am going to give always at all the things, all the cases. Okay. C out, comma sum, concatenation symbol, which is equal to A plus B plus C, and end model. It is similar to your C language manipulation. Okay. That is one method, behavior level method. The same full adder I can write in structural level method. So structural level method, what I have to do is, I am going to know the structural diagram of it. And I am going to give what are the gates I am going to have, AND gates, three AND gates. According to the circuit diagram, I am mapping it, OR gate, I am providing XOR gate. I have to label the inputs and outputs according to it, AND model. For this, I have to know the circuit diagram of my design. Similarly, when I am calling for input and output, FA, the unit under test, I have to give the sensitivity list. Okay. Initial begin, A value, B value, C in value, end. And then instead of using that method for all the 8 combinations, I can provide a for loop. For loop, I is equal to 0, I is less than 8. So 0 to 7, the input will be given, I equal to I plus 1. So totally 0 to 7, the two table inputs have been provided. So I am providing that as I, which has been converted into A, B and C in signal and assigned for every 10 delay, okay, period of delay. So every 10 period of delay it is assigned. And then instead of using a dollar display, I can use another DAS command, dollar monitor. So dollar monitor is similar to dollar display. Only thing is there you have to give for each and every case individual display signal. We are not going to give individual display signal. We are going to give a one monitor signal. It will display the total truth table. Okay, dollar monitor percentage D nanoseconds for every 10 nanoseconds it will be providing A plus B plus Cn. What is value of A? What is the value of B? What is the value of Cn? The outputs, the corresponding output sum and carry will be given. The time period, dollar time, will be providing the time. Okay. So this dollar display is nothing but giving the line finally. The single line statement means dollar display can be used. Multiple lines means dollar monitor has to be used. Okay. End the dollar stop for ending the program execution. End the end model. Similarly, using this full adder, we can design a 4-bit adder. 4-bit adder, adder underscore 4-bit. It display says that it is a 4-bit adder program. What we are going to have, we will be having the output of sum, which is a 5-bit data, 0, 4, colon, 0. It is nothing but sum 0, sum 1, sum 2, sum 3, sum 4. Input, we will be having a 4-bit data. AF0, AF1, AF2, AF3. BF0, BF1, BF2, BF3. Typical Indian model we are performing. And then intermediate signals, we'll be having the carry generated for each stage. C is equal to 0, C is equal to 1, C is equal to 2. Okay. So already a 4-bit adder you would have designed in the AF0, AF1, AF2, AF3. B0, B1, B2, B3. We are performing the addition. We'll be having S0. A carry not, S1, carry 1, S2, carry 2, S3, carry 3. Okay. The intermediate signals, whatever we have defined, is C. So these three intermediate signals, C0, C2. This is our bias. Okay. These are the outputs. So C3 has been assigned as S4. That's why we are having the vector 4 down to 0 sum. And this has been declared as A, 3 down to 0. This has been declared as B, 3 down to 0. A 4-bit data. So what we are going to do, for this case, we will be having a half adder. For this case, we will be having a full adder. For this case, to implement, you will be having a full adder. For this case, you will be having a full adder. You will be getting the output for this. So how to write the code? You will be having a full adder. Okay, so the unit has been called and we are going to map. What are the things we have to map? A0, so we are mapping A0 here. Okay, B0, we are mapping B0. Okay, and then we can map 0 because either we can use a half adder. Instead of using the half adder, I am making this as full adder. Okay, if I want to make it as full adder, the carry has to be given as 0, so I am giving 0. 1-bit, 0. Okay, so binary. What will be the output? You will be getting S0, that is nothing but sum 0 and carry C0. Okay, sum 0 and C0. So next case, what we are going to do is nothing but I am going to force A1 for the second. So what I am doing, the unit 0. I am giving the unit, this unit as unit 0. This unit as unit 1. Unit 2 for this one. Unit 3 for this one. Okay. So unit 1, A1, B1, C0, and you will be getting your sum 2, sum 1, carry 1. Okay. So next, U2, what is the inputs? A2, B2, C1. So A2, B2, C1, sum 2, carry 2, you will be getting. Similarly, U3, A3, B3, C2, sum 3, sum 4. So you will be getting all the 5-bit output. Okay. So finally end the model. So this is your main program. The calling program full adder. You have to add the full adder. Module full adder. ABC input. Sum and carry. Output sum. Output carry. Input A. Input B. Input C. Okay. And then I am giving assign. Sum is equal to A XR B XR C. What I have to know here? I have to know the Boolean equation. So if I know the Boolean equation, A XR B XR C will be generating sum. carry is being generated by A and B or B and C or C and A. Okay, I am giving that assigned statement, end model. So next, to execute this, I have to write a test bench. Model test bench, I am going to have a register, whatever inputs I have declared as registers. So registers TA, TB, then wire, the outputs, T-sum. So you have declared there A, B, sum. Here I can declare as different label, no problem. Okay, or I can give the same label. So most of the time I am given the first example with the same label case. Here I am given different label, your case. But it must have some sensibility. So you are going to test means you have to give the test A, B. Okay. After that, the outputs has been declared. And then integer I, J. Why is our integer? It is like C language integers which have been used as a variables. So here also I can use the keyword integer. But in C language I will be using int. Okay? So here instead of int the keyword is integer. Okay, I am declaring integer ij. Next, for looping statement. Initial, so the model of our testing, initial begin for I is equal to 0, I is less than 16, that is 0 to 15. So 4 bit data is the input term. A 4 bit data, B 4 bit data. So how many possible combinations will be there? So 4 bit data means 0 to 15 will be having. So less than 16 I am giving. Or you can give less than or equal to 15. So your case, sir, how to write? There are different styles, you can follow any style. This is one method I am showing. Okay. 0 to less than 15, I plus 1, begin. For J equal to 0 to less than 16, J is equal to J plus 1, begin. You are giving T A is equal to I, T B is equal to J. So what happens for every iteration 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 it will be imposed. You just add T A, T B, the values, the other monitor will be giving the output for half adder. Okay. So if I want to include a full adder, I have to include another vector. So how I will be declaring? For loops 2. Instead of that, I have to give 3 for loops and ABC. That is your way you have to make. So I have given for this for half adder. You have to try for full adder. Then end mod. Okay. So you will be getting the specification, the circuit hardware simulation. Okay. RBL level diagram will be there. So I have to take the RBL level diagram and you have to. So for N bit, you will be using the data flow level. For N bit, you can also use this concatenation statement, X plus Y plus C in full adder definition. And then you will be declaring as instead of 4 bit or 8 bit or 10 bit, you can get the input as a value. Okay. And N minus 2 to 0, you can create the carry flag. And less than N, we can generate the value for your 4 bit adder, 8 bit adder, 16 bit adder. According to that, the n value can be given. So it is 15 or 14 or 30, like that. So what we can do, 0 to 15 I want to get means I will be declaring this as 16. Okay, so 16 bit adder I can decide. 8 bit adder I want to decide. You can just replace this here. So a common program which can be used for any bit adder design. So you can give a X, Y, C in sum of carrier and it will be performing the operations. So iteration method, I am assigning full adder this value. And another case, same thing, you can also perform using the integers equal to if case. Okay. Instead of for loop, you can also use if statement. Okay. If this condition is satisfied, this will be assigned. Or this will be assigned according to your requirement. So you can use the for loop and these statements for generating any type of adder, 4 bit adder, 16 bit adder, 32 bit adder. This is the first part of your assignment. Okay, assignment is nothing but you have to design an adder, subtractor, multiplier, divider. Okay, so for that, these are the fundamentals. So using this, you have to make adders. You can give the instruction end generate. So generating the iterated design. So I have given some sample n bit adders. You can refer this or you can develop by yourself, no problem. Okay. You can Google. example, I develop different types of adders for your assignment. So I want the unique adder designed by you, unique multiplier, unique divider like that. So if you want to get the full marks for your assignment, it is very difficult to get 10 marks from the assignment.